Hey everyone, in this video I wanted to talk about Vexo's redesign app within their designer. Now I talked about that before in this video right here, but I wanted to go over it again because I believe they updated and made it even better. I'm going to show you exactly how it works. So if you know Vexo's, they have professionally designed templates and you can use those templates and change it to fit your niche. So some of the benefits of this is you can take some of those things that's not in your niche, but add the design that's in your niche to complete it. Or if you have a bestseller, you have used one of those templates and they're a bestseller for you, you can scale it out. So I'm going to show you how to do both of those things in Vexo's and how easy it is. And I'm going to just do a tutorial step by step so you can see how it is. And at the end of this video, I'll actually show you how much this is if you want to get into Vexo's. If you're not in Vexo's right now, there's a 7-day trial as well. So lots to see in this video. Let's get into Vexo's right now and I'll show you how all of this works with AI. All right, so here I am on Vexo's, vexo's.com/homepage. If you've signed in, this is what you'll see. If you're new, you probably see something slightly different. They have a ton of things on here. So just to go show you what Vexo's is mainly known for, I think, and they started with this, is look at all these templates for t-shirts and other things. So if you're looking for that, like professionally designed t-shirts, see some of those, and you can come in here and just edit them. But the thing I wanna show you is the merch designer. You can see it's new. I love this one. It actually has one of the best vectorizers online anywhere. I did a video for that. I'll have to put it up here somewhere, but when you go to the designer, you have access to those templates too. So take a look at these, all these, and it's, you can see the latest one here, streetwear. If you're into streetwear designs, check that out. So cool. There's lettering, so just fonts and text, but some really cool layouts with that. Vintage designs, which is nice. Floral, so there's a bunch. Cartoon, I'll go through all of them. Surreal. These are some really cool ones that I probably wouldn't do myself, but it's nice that other people have done it, so you can take advantage of this. Look at that, cat, dog. I'm guessing it's National Dog Month. There's a lot of Dog Month things there. And trippy, so some really trippy looking ones. Pretty cool. All right, so I'm just gonna go to featured. And you have My Projects and From Scratch as well if you wanna just start with nothing. I would suggest if you haven't done a t-shirt design at all, if you're using Vexo's, I would start with the templates. It's just so much easier and I'm gonna show you how to make it even easier. So let me try and pick one of these. Here, Bad Witch. This one's kind of cool. It's, you know, close to Halloween. So it's gonna bring that template into the designer. It's gonna put it on a t-shirt. I like to turn it off just because I wanna just see the design. But if you wanna leave it on, just for reference, like where it is, you can do that too. The thing I want to show you that's really, really cool though, is I can click on this and this is the thing, redesign. So this is going to use AI and I'm going to click on this so you can see how it does it. And a number of results. So I can do one result if you want, and each result is just one credit. So I can do up to 4 and each one is one credit, so that's 4. I'm just gonna do 2. 2. Preserve design essence, yes, that's what we want. You don't have to do that, but I think that really helps if you wanna kinda keep the same idea. And so what I'm gonna type in here is this. Pirate drinking coffee instead of a witch, right? Because we have a witch here. So that's what you wanna do, the thing you want instead of the thing you have. So that's how easy it is to write it. Let's just pretend that we have a pirate, a coffee pirate store for whatever reason. They're both really popular, by the way, pirates and coffee, so why not? So I'm gonna hit that and I'm gonna just hit redesign and it's gonna put the 2 right here. So we'll have 2 examples and once we see the 2 examples, then we can put it. I believe it's using Nano Banana, I'm not exactly sure, but this is kind of what Nano Banana does, is takes a design and use the same elements. It's really good at using the same elements, but making something different, just some of those changes. So if it's not using Nano Banana, I'll be really surprised, but We'll see how it comes out. So I would expect a pirate with a nose like this, probably sitting in the chair. Maybe not. I'll see. Yeah, it is. Let's see this one. It actually flipped it the other way. So all you have to do is click on here, and there you go, the pirate in the chair. And it flipped it. Let's see this other one. So you got two choices. And there. I don't know. Which one do you think is better? We got this one, drinking coffee. He's got a pig leg. Or this one. I like this one. I think the second one has more of that witch feel with the teeth and everything like that. So it says bad witch somewhere, but guess what? This is actually text. So I can change this to say pirate. Boom. And look, it fits the same spot. Same thing with summer. I'm going to say, not summer. Coffee. Boom. Now it says pirate coffee. And of course, we can change this text in down here to something else. But I'm just going to show you that. So yeah, pretty cool, right? I wanted to show you some other examples of this so you can see how good this is in changing something. So let me show you that now. So here's a pirate coffee for this mushroom. I replaced this mushroom. Here's the pirate coffee replacing this skull. Check it out. It's the same style here. And here are a few more. Pirate coffee replacing the angel, one of the templates. Pirate coffee replacing this weird looking surreal wolf, I guess is what it is, blue. And here's a pirate coffee replacing kind of this Japanese style right there. Isn't that cool? So it can do all of this in Vexels, which I think is really cool. So if you don't have pirate coffee and you do corgi like me, like this corgi right here, you could change this into a corgi. You could change that into a corgi. You could change that all with the same style. The AI knows what style it is. I think this one would be a cool one. Instead of a cat, put a corgi. But whatever you want, this would actually make more sense. The dog with the corgi. I think I actually will do that. So that's that one. So let's say that you have a bestseller. Let's do another one. I'm going to go into cartoon here. And I saw one earlier with it. Yeah, this one. Okay. So let's say you used Vexels and this template or something like it was your bestseller. Check that out. It's so cool. Okay, so I'm going to turn off that and we're going to scale this. So at first, I'm going to do a different thing. So I'm going to do the redesign again. Okay, cool. That's fine. And then we're going to do we want this preserve design essence. We can do different styles, but we want to keep this style. And the prompt for this one is similar to the other one, a corgi, because I really want to see instead of a dinosaur. You may have to do one at a time, but still, I'll show you examples after this one of how you can scale things and put a different graphic, but keep the same style. I think this is a great example of this. Because if you have an animal eating ramen that does really well for you, makes a lot of sales, why not try that? I actually did that with my own corgi eating ramen. You might see on Amazon a panda eating ramen, a cat eating ramen. I think I did a sloth eating ramen and so on. So this is kind of the same take of that. There it is, the corgi. Okay, let's see. I'm gonna click on it. Yes, there it is in the background. Nice. And I believe I can put it in the back, center back. There you go. And I could make it bigger. Very cool. And I don't know what this says, so I might have to do some research and change it to say corgi eating ramen, or I believe this might be ramen. I'm not so sure. So yeah, check that out. Corgi eating ramen. Now we could do it with other things and stuff. Now I believe you can do Command Z and go backwards. Let's see. Command Z, Command Z, Command Z. Yeah, and it's there. And this is a template anyway, so I think you can do that. So have fun with this. This is really cool. Oh, let me show you more examples of how to scale this out. How to use this idea where you have the best design, your design that makes a lot of sales, and now just make a lot more of these so that you get a better chance to get a sale. All right, check these out. We got the mushroom, but I have a broccoli and a pineapple in the same style. I love this pineapple one. That's so cool. We have this one right here where the original was a bird with an accordion, and you can change out the animal and the instrument. So tiger playing a guitar in the same style, owl playing the drums in the same style, and so on. Another cool one. And here's even more. There's one with a toy here. You can see it's a toy cat and a toy dog and so on. Here's one with I think that's a pumpkin. It's really wild. And you can see the same style with the girl and a dog and a pizza. And here's another one where, like, let's say your designs are all about dogs. So you can take the dog doing different things. So a dog, dogs in the car, dogs on a jet ski, dogs on skateboards and so on. So that's a fun one as well. So this is a way so you can take your best sellers, use that redesign AI in Vexels and change it up super quick. And again, only one credit, so pretty cool. All right, last thing I wanted to show you, I have a link in the description for Vexels. It'll take you here, and this is kind of the page if you don't have Vexels already. 25% off, only $10 a month for the starter, $21 for the medium. And so you can see how many credits. You get 200 credits, so you can do 200 of those every month. And then you can have up to 100 designer projects for the lower one. And for the medium one here, 600 credits, so three times for twice the price, so a little more than twice the price, and unlimited designer projects, so pretty cool. And I didn't talk about this, but they give you 2 custom design credits too, so you can actually get a custom, ask them to create a design for you. It's pretty cool. I've used it before and it's pretty neat. So you can just, it's like kind of having a Fiverr person do designs for you for it. So you can try this for free, 7-day free trial right here. Try it out, see how you like it, and you know, go from there. If you don't like it, that's fine. But I wanted to show you options that you have here. This is another option. You don't have to get all the different apps out there online, but find the one that works best for you. And if this one does, then this is how it works. And you know, you got downloads and all these things, and check out all the templates. And if you're doing more than just t-shirts, they have that too. So go and explore, see if this is great for you. I have a bunch of other videos as well. Like I said, the vectorizer on that merch designer is one of the best ones. I use it all the time for that. So go try that out as well. So there you go. That's the updated redesign feature with AI in Vexels. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you, so you can see exactly how to use this in practice and hopefully get more sales this Q4. If you want to see another video about it, I'll put that video I did a few months ago with the AI designer, so you can see even more examples of it in action. Thanks again for watching, and as always, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.